Hey guys, welcome to my channel. This is my first YouTube video, which is long awaited. Believe me, I've been meaning to do it, I've been wanting to do it. I'm just a little bit lazy and a procrastinator, and finally I'm doing it, it's happening. This better be posted. If you're watching it, I did it. So yeah, if you want to know how to get this look, it's just a pink tone half cut crease, then keep on watching. Please subscribe, please like this video, please comment down what you want to see in the future of this channel, and follow all my social media links. They'll be linked down below, and I hope you enjoy. So I'm going in with my Tarte Shape Tape concealer in light medium to prime my eyes, and I'm putting kind of a thick layer underneath my eyes and like right beneath my brow. So I'm going to go ahead and clean up my brow with this Zoeva flat little concealer brush. I got it in a set for Christmas. I'll link it down below. I'm blending the rest of that out toward my eye and around my face. And then I'm going to go in with a Zoeva concealer blending brush and just buff out that concealer and make sure everything is even and has a nice canvas for me to put my eyeshadow on top of. So I don't set my eyes because I find that my eyeshadow is more pigmented without setting it. So I'm just going straight into my Morphe 35B palette and taking the two colors that are marked on the screen. And I'm taking them on this really fluffy wide brush from Zoeva again. And I'm just going to kind of stipple it into my eye while doing windshield wiper motions to get the color on there. And we're using that as my transition shade. Okay, so now I'm taking my Morphe, I'm taking my Modern Renaissance palette from Anastasia Beverly Hills, and the pink color at the top right next to my broken brown color. And I'm just putting that right underneath the pink we just put in. It's kind of like close in color to the one we just used, but it adds dimension. So I'm putting that in, and then I'm blending it out with a Morphe M447 brush. In between each color I put on, I go in with the M447 and blend it out. Make sure everything's just like blended super seamlessly. So I'm just re-intensifying that color with a Morphe R39 brush. And then going in again with the M447 to blend it all through and make everything just super flawless and pretty. Okay, now I'm taking my Jaclyn Hill palette from Morphe, and I'm taking this rustic red color. And I'm taking it on a Morphe R39 brush, and I'm just gonna pack it into the outer part of my eye and then slowly blend it toward the front of my eye, if that makes sense. So now I'm taking the M447 again and just blending those colors all together. And once again, I'm re-intensifying that bricky color. Now I'm taking my Kat Von D Saint and Sinner palette, and I'm gonna take the black in the palette and just put a little bit of that in the outer corner of my eye, just to continue darkening up the outer corner. All right, so I'm gonna cut my crease. I did a half cut crease, and I used
the Shape Tape concealer, and now I'm setting it with the Laura Mercier powder. Then I'm re-intensifying the black with this little like flat shader brush. Now I'm taking the two eyeshadow toppers from the St. Insigner palette mixed together and putting that on top of the area that we cut the crease at. And I sprayed this with some Mario Badescu rose water to make everything a lot more intense. So after this, I'm gonna go back in with that black and just blend those two shades together. And now I'm gonna curl my lashes and apply some mascara from L'Oreal. And I finished the other eye and the rest of my face off camera, along with my lashes, my falsies, I put those on off camera. And now I'm taking that pink color again and running it underneath my lower lash line. I'm popping on some mascara and I'm done. So thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Like, comment, and subscribe for more.